You're not supposed to do that. Now we wake up. Go, 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 go. Ah!
Ah! First touch, remove. That's what happens in the game. First touch, remove.
Pout Bay United are a team in trouble.
Stay simple, concentrate.
Formed just over a year ago, they are playing their second season in South Africa's semi-pro league.
Ah, come on.
With five games left, the team are currently just one place above the relegation zone.
At the moment, we're sitting fourth from bottom, and it's quite precarious.
It's not just the threat of relegation on everyone's minds. To join the league, the team's founders had to pay a 10,000 rand entry fee. And with half the country's population living on less than that a year, that's a huge amount at stake.
So there's a bit of pressure on us.
There's someone out there, come on! Have to move!
4 months ago, Coach Mornay was brought in to try to change the team's fortunes.
Hey, hold it and go forward! Aye, that first touch, come on!
But things are still looking very uncertain.
We're still in that dogfight at the bottom.
Now time is running out. Every goal and every point could be the difference between staying in the league or losing everything.
We just need to start winning some games.
Hoping to turn the team's fortune around is South African footballing legend Matthew Booth.
Feels great to be back in Cape Town. It's a beautiful, beautiful part of the world.
His strength and ability as a centre-back has seen him represent his country at an Olympic Games and Football World Cup. Matthew is now tasked with helping to save Hout Bay United from relegation.
They've been struggling a little bit throughout the season, and we're here just to try and encourage them and put them through a little bit of an intensive programme.
The team are aware that a former Olympian is coming to train them, but at the moment they have no idea who that person may be.
I'm very excited, man, to see the coach.
I'm kind of nervous, but yeah, I'm ready. I'm so much excited.
I'm certainly hoping that we'll be able to get the best out of them by the end of the week.
And we're here to learn, physically, mentally, footballing-wise. We're ready for anything.
It's now time for the team to find out who their Olympic coach is.
Thanks very much for the welcome and the invite. I just want to apologize. I know a couple of you guys were expecting Alex Ferguson, so sorry to disappoint you. But no, I do have nearly 20 years experience in the professional game. And I certainly look forward to training with you. And I'm very competitive, so, you know, I want to win on Friday, just like the rest of you guys.
He's a legend, so cool. He'll have everyone's respect. Players will be excited. So, yeah, fantastic.
I look up to him, he's my role model.
First thing is very basic. We're just going to get the passing right, okay? Just down on the outside of the square, just pass it around on your toes if you can.
If the team are to win at the end of the week, it's essential that they improve their basic skills.
Okay, let's get it passing. Go on. I want tempo, guys.
He's on the ground.
A solid first touch is vital to keeping possession and moving the ball forward.
It's building up slowly, up, it's a possession game. Keeping the ball away from them. Two touches now, you've got two touches, well done. You have to have it. Now you press tight, come on. Oh, well done.
Adding the second touch gives the player on the ball greater control over his pass.
You've got two touches, you have to take it. Yeah, you have to.
But reduces the amount of time he has to get rid of it. And for some of the team, it's not going so well.
Come on. It's all about accuracy and quality at the end of the day. To be able to pass a nice, nicely weighted ball to the correct foot of your teammate, it's not easy, it needs practice.
Matthew has played football in South Africa for over two decades. Here in Hout Bay, it's not taken long for him to notice a problem with the team.
What I picked up immediately when you were playing ball there were two circles. All right. I like to encourage you guys to mix a bit more, yeah? You're all one team, you're all brothers, you're working together for one goal. So let's mix it up, okay? All right.
It's essential for the team to mix and work together as a single unit if they hope to win at the end of the week.
There's no tackling, okay? Yellow is playing with yellow, blue is playing with blue.
It's always good to learn from somebody that comes in new and picks up a few things which, you know, which will help us going forward.
Tempo, tempo, come on! Lift it! Okay, come in, lads.
It's the end of the first training session, and although the team might be impressed with their Olympic coach, he's unimpressed with their lack of effort.
If I can just say one thing, and that's, you know, you can't go about your business doing things like that. Every little pass, as simple as it seems, it's got to be to perfection or to the best of your ability, otherwise you're not going to improve.
It's day two and time for the players' second training session with their Olympian coach. Key to Matthew's training plan is using repetition to gradually build and develop the skills he's teaching the team, session by session.
I'm going to do a basic warm-up, quick feet, and then really the passing drills are what's going to be the main content for tonight. It's not easy. You've just killed your partner, all right, by giving that ball. Guys, you've got to concentrate on your pass, otherwise you're killing your teammate, okay? I'm just trying to emphasize the fact that you can't just pass for passing's sake. You've got to pass with accuracy and think of your teammate. Otherwise, you're going to put him into trouble, you know?
Nice! Stay on your feet, cover!
They're definitely more focused. They're concentrating more. The fact that he's an ex-pro that they know, it has a lot of weight, you know? It's massive that he's been there and he's done it before.
All right.
It's the end of the second session with Matthew, and after the lack of effort put in by the team last time, things have improved.
I think they all realise how important Friday is going to be. Basically, this is going to be a chance for them to get to push themselves well out of the relegation zone. Hopefully the pressure doesn't get to them too much, but hopefully we've laid the foundation for Friday, a good performance on Friday.
For 20-year-old Soso, football is more than just a game.
This is my inside of my house. I've got my TV there, I've got my DVD, where I watch some of the games on Sundays when I'm free. And this is where I sleep, this is my bed. And my father died on 2004. It was me and my younger sister. And then my mom wasn't working, so it was hard for her to provide my food and my money for transport to go to school. So I thought I'll just stop in school and find myself a job. I don't want to live here for the rest of my life. And I think football is going to help me move out of this location. Like it's fun because it keeps you out of the street, like on the bad things, like being a criminal or something, or gangster. It helped me a lot to not join those kind of things.
With just one more training session to go, Matthew's changing tack and has asked the team to meet him at the beach.
I'm not sure what's going to happen today, but definitely we're not swimming.
This is just to get them a little bit relaxed and again working on the team spirit, communication, trying to break down the whatever racial tension there was to begin with.
For Captain Newton, it's the perfect opportunity to build his connection with the team.
The point of the game, your captains are going to go fill up the buckets halfway. Your captain is then going to place the bucket in the middle, and you've got to hold the bucket with your feet, okay? Once you've positioned yourself underneath the bucket, you're then going to take your shoes off one at a time. Once all of you have done that, you are the winner.
As they do the exercise, Matthew wants the players to only speak English, so that when they're on the pitch together as a team, it becomes second nature.
And off you go, come on. Make that circle, Jen.
Keep pulling to the string. Woo!
It's fun for the team, and the challenge is doing exactly what Matthew had hoped. They're working together and communicating in English without thinking about it.
Yeah, it's tight.
Someone's going to get wet.
Matthew, they got the greenie here that's got a size 12 shoe. So he's just holding everything over there.
It's close, but Newton's team finished first.
Yeah! Yeah, very successful. They all seemed to speak English, one language, and that was obviously necessary for the task to be done successfully.
Talking, much talking, team building, that was fun. I enjoyed it.
On the pitch, Matthew is preparing for his final training session with the team.
We're going to tone it down a bit and focus a lot more on the back four. Okay, so we've got a game tomorrow, right? So we're going to be here for an hour. Okay, so let's have quality because it's going to be short, okay? This is the exercise, all right? So I've got the ball, you're closing me down, Zwei, and I'm passing and following. You go there and you pass it.
But there's a problem. With the team not used to such an intensive training regime, the fatigue is starting to show.
Close in. Wake up, guys. Close in. Go, go, go. You've got to be alert. Passing, guys. Come on.
And as the exercise goes on, things aren't getting any better.
Come on, guys. You can't be standing on hands on your hips, yeah? As a team, you can't switch off. Otherwise, the whole machine is broken, okay? Everybody's got to be switched on for the full 90, yeah?
Having seen gaps in the team's back four, Matthew's next drill is focused on how they defend crosses.
As a defender, the best thing to do is to head the ball as high as possible and out to the flanks.
If I can see, I can win the ball.
If I go up, just drop behind me.
And cover.
Next three, here we go. Next three. Knock it.
It's essential for the defense to remain focused and organized.
Keep it on the ground, simple. Out! Push! You can't make mistakes near post.
It's been a disappointing final session, but with the game less than 24 hours away, there's nothing more Matthew can do.
I'm very nervous. So this is our home game, we have to win.
They've put in a hard graft this week, which is appreciated. They've reacted very well to myself. And hopefully it's been beneficial. So tomorrow will tell.
It's the day of the big game, and the team and their Olympic coach, Matthew Booth, arrive at the pitch to prepare. After a week of intensive training and guidance, Hout Bay will need to win today if they hope to stand any chance of avoiding relegation.
Take the pointers that you've learned from this week. Constructive talk throughout the 90 minutes, yeah? That's important.
I don't have to say much about what this game means, eh? This is our home ground, all right? Make sure we make life difficult for them. Make sure we go out with heart.
UWC are just one place above Hout Bay in the league. 3 points for either team today could be enough to save them from relegation.
Go, boys!
We've just seen Matt's brought a level of professionalism that, you know, it's given us a bit of a wake-up call, really.
Both sides are off to a nervous start, and not 2 minutes in, a long ball from UWC catches the back four off guard.
Hey, ball down! I think both teams are just settling down into the game and a bit rushed and a bit nervy from both sides. It's a great ball. Nice, that's better. Well done.
With just minutes left before half-time, a missed clearance from UWC gives striker Gabba the perfect opportunity.
Oh yes! Gabba! Fantastic piece of skill with a very, very neat finish as well.
Well done, boys.
At half-time, it's 1-0 Hout Bay.
On the whole, brilliant first half. Very pleased for you. Great finish, yeah? All right, nice build-up. I've got two concerns. Unnecessary long balls, because when you're passing the ball, you're outplaying them. You're murdering them. So why are you playing long balls? My other concern is that we are getting murdered from set pieces. You've got to be talking, all right? Commanding in that area. You don't want him to go 1-1.
If Hout Bay keep their lead for the next 45 minutes, the 3 points will be theirs. But at the restart, it's UWC who are in control.
Well, the opposition are obviously chasing the game, and they've upped the tempo a little bit.
Come
Hout Bay are under pressure. But the back four have taken on board Matthew's advice and are holding strong.
The game's a bit too fast-paced for my liking.
As Hout Bay pressure UWC in the box, an own goal cements their lead.
Go!
Go!
Oh, yes!
Yes,
yes, yes!
Hout Bay 2, UWC 0.
You know, they've got to remain very concentrated and, you know, until the final whistle.
Let's work!
At the final whistle, it's 2-0 Hout Bay, a decisive victory that's earned the team a desperately needed 3 points.
Very happy, ecstatic for the lads. Well-deserved win. Outplayed their opponents completely. They were fantastic, you know.
We play more with heart, and guys were motivating each other.
Everybody give yourself a round of applause, eh? All right.
Some of the football that you played out there in patches was lovely. Ultimately, it's about work and wanting it, determination, wanting the 3 points more than the opposition. Well done, guys. Keep it up. Eh?
It was a great experience with Matthew Wood coaching us for the week. Yeah.
I think the players have changed. The attitude, the enthusiasm, the commitment.
We were looking for a win, and we got a win today. And that makes me happy because we didn't disappoint anyone.
I'm ecstatic with the results. The moral of the story is very clear, you know, you put in the hard yards, you put in the hard work, and you will get results at the end of the day.